When I was a boy, I started to hide things in the linings of the garments. Things that only I knew were there. Secrets.
Good morning.
Hi, folks. I'm Ignatiy Vishnevetsky.
I'm Alex Dowd.
Today, we're talking about the latest from Paul Thomas Anderson, possibly the last from Daniel Day-Lewis, Phantom Thread.
Welcome to Film Club.
Phantom Thread is set sometime after World War II, probably the 1950s in London. It's the first film that Paul Thomas Anderson has made that takes place outside of the United States. Mm-hmm. And in many ways, it feels like a classic gothic romance that's been transplanted into the world of 50s fashion. The world of this dressmaker, Reynolds Woodcock, played by Daniel Day-Lewis, who's head of the House of Woodcock. And obviously the fact that fashion houses are referred to as houses has a slightly gothic House of Usher
right,
feel
right.
to it, who basically meets this woman. She's working as a waitress in a restaurant. She becomes his muse. And it's about their relationship. They're somewhat toxic and symbiotic relationship.
Well, but I'm not sure how toxic it really is. And I think one of the things that I really like about this movie is that it sort of understands relationships as cycles.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that the whole film is about very centered on the relationship between these two people and on the kind of push-pull between them and the power dynamic between them in this house. And in this relationship.
Not unlike The Master.
Very much so like The Master. But I think that this is maybe one of his sort of most emotionally direct movies,
mm-hmm.
you know?
But also in some ways one of his strangest. It's a very mm-hmm. it's a very eerie and intentionally quite cryptic film. But
do you think it's that cryptic? You look at The Master and you say that Freddie Quell's psychology in The Master is this puzzle,
mm-hmm.
sort of. And I feel like I've seen that movie 10 times probably, and I'm still sort of sorting out who this guy is, what their relationship really means. I think it's pretty clear what he's doing in Phantom Thread. And I think he's examining a particular kind of power dynamic between two people in a relationship that I think is in its own way kind of hopeful.
But I guess when I talk about it being cryptic, I mean more the approach he takes, because
mm-hmm.
I would say this is the film that feels the most Kubrickian out of all of his movies. It has
really,
a
certain, you think so? Okay.
I do think so. I think it has a kind of remove to it. But at the same time, its narrative mostly moves kind of in sensual directions. There's a lot about food. I don't want to spoil the mm-hmm. plot, but there's a lot involving food and appetites
mm-hmm.
that's kind of wound in there in a very, to me, in a very enigmatic way.
Mm-hmm.
Both actors are really great. I mean,
yeah.
Lewis, it's in many ways a more subtle and closed off performance than the one he gave in Anderson's There Will Be Blood. He's also using his natural accent, I think,
right.
for maybe the first time.
Well, he's playing a different kind of tyrant in this, mm-hmm. I feel like. In There Will Be Blood, he's this volcanic, this man who is basically his default emotion is anger.
Yeah.
In this, he's not as, in some ways, he's the polar opposite of Daniel Plainview.
Mm-hmm.
He's this sort of upper crust, sort of very dignified man, whereas Daniel Plainview is just this, a lot of the time is just kind of this raving lunatic. But they have this same kind of, they want control over their worlds. And they have the same kind of tyrannical relationship sometimes with the people in their lives.
And Vicky Krieps, who plays Alma, this woman who kind of enters his life, she's also very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
I think part of what I like about both of their performances is that there is a version of the story where she could be played as very naive,
mm-hmm.
which this movie doesn't do, and Woodcock could be played as very cold, but he's actually... He has a charm to him. He seems like someone who would be entertaining to be around at a dinner party or something.
You're right. There's a version of this story where he's just this block of ice, and she's just this young woman who's sort of been wrapped up in his fame and his power. But the movie very slowly reveals that they have dimensions that aren't necessarily immediately clear. I think a lot of the movie is about them sort of coaxing those qualities out of each other.
I feel as if I've been looking for you for a very long time. You look beautiful, very beautiful. I have things I want to do, things I simply cannot do without you.